Hello, I'm Grimgrindle, and welcome to this bonus episode of Witch v. Witch. When I recorded the finale episode, I said all good things must come to an end, and indeed they must, but as it turns out, Witch v. Witch is not quite done yet. You see, when I uploaded episode 4, the Jagosium episode, it was pointed out in the comments that I had forgotten to do the challenge, Nine Ball Nightmare, but by then this entire series had been recorded, and even uploaded with the schedule set. And further, I had also already planned out what I wanted to do in May. However, now that Star Wars Month has ended, before I get started with anything else, I figured I might as well chuck up this bonus episode addressing the challenge I neglected. Quite helpfully, it wasn't very difficult to have a good look at Grunty's vehicle in this challenge, because for the most part it's only one part thick, and also you can tell that the wedges are light wedges because they have no curvature. And so with her vehicle replicated and painted, it was time to get into Nine Ball Nightmare. My usual tactic when doing Nine Ball Nightmare is to keep the ball away from Grunty, because usually my vehicle is considerably better and faster than Grunty's, and so it's pretty easy just to keep the balls out of her reach. However, since this is Witch v. Witch, our vehicles are exactly the same, and so the prospect of outrunning her and keeping the balls away from her are not exactly great. In light of this, for this challenge, I instead decided to adopt pretty much the exact opposite approach, and instead of keeping the balls away from Grunty, I decided to keep Grunty away from the balls. And, as you can see, this tactic actually works rather well. Because both the vehicles are wedge-shaped, and because they both have the same power, they get locked up pretty well, and if you can connect them properly together, it really slows down any of Grunty's efforts. I also attempted to land my vehicle on top of hers to see if it would slow down her vehicle anymore. It did not, but you can't know these things unless you try. And so with the first round victory going to me, it was time to move on to the second round. This challenge is 9 rounds long, and in my opinion goes far too long. I know why they did it, it's because it's a 9-ball challenge and so you needed 9 different balls and so therefore you needed 9 different rounds, but really they should have just abandoned the namesake and made it maybe 4 balls or 5 balls, because I really feel after the first maybe 3 rounds, the challenge doesn't really bring anything new to the table. Which is probably being pretty well illustrated on the screen right now, because much like the first round, for most of the second round here, all that was happening was that Grunty and my vehicle were circling each other as they were locked in place. But further illustrated is also the fact that I said the first 3 rounds do have a little bit of variety, as shown by Grunty eventually realizing that her flying vehicle can actually just fly away from my deadlock. However, rather fortunately, she learned this lesson far too late, and the second round point still went to me. Moving straight along to round 3, it started out much the same, and so I've sped up the footage a fair bit as you can tell, but to mix things up, Grunty learned her lesson about flying a lot earlier, and I too learned a lesson for myself. Namely, that Grunty's vehicle really doesn't like being tipped. It seems to have a very weird center of gravity, which I can only assume comes from her seat because our vehicles are the same but I don't have this issue, and if you just nudge her off of her center of gravity slightly, she starts to rotate so quickly that I could probably put spinners in the tag of this video and collect on that trend. Destabilizing her in this fashion pretty much became my policy in each round to follow, not only because it looks really funny, but also because it works well, and so round 3 went to me. Which means, as you might have figured out, if you're good at pattern recognition or basic mathematics, we're now up to round 4. When round 4 started out, I was a little bit worried because she immediately turned her vehicle around and went in the opposite direction. This is because the ball she's after is behind her, which is a slight issue because, as you know, our vehicles are the same speed, and so the prospect of catching her vehicle if both our vehicles are going at their top speed is not exactly great. As such, by the time I caught her, she was already lasering the ball, and I really didn't have much time to do anything. So round 4 goes to Grunty. Which brings us straight on to round 5, although this time with more vengeance than the other rounds, and as we go into round 5, we're faced with a very similar issue to round 4, although this time airborne. Luckily, however, as the sped up footage will attest, Grunty's not nearly as good a pilot as she is a driver. Once caught, I immediately went into attempts to destabilize her, however, unfortunately, these attempts were not quite successful as the last time I tried it, and round 5, just as round 4, went to Grunty. Which, on the one hand, is rather disappointing, but on the other, we're around mid-video, which is the perfect point to have a bit of a spike in the conflict. It's good for the story, folks, especially if we're trying to establish an underdog recovery. And so round 6. Time for that recovery we've been talking about. Luckily, this round saw Grunty going straight for me, which meant it was a lot easier to achieve a lock and to delay her significantly. There was lots more pushing each other around in circles, a lot of skidding, and once she became airborne, a lot more spins and flips. I've gone and sped up this round also because, as I indicated earlier, it doesn't really bring much new to the table. But as you can see, as a bit of a combo breaker, we snatched the victory away from Grunty and won another round. To begin with, round 7 had me slightly worried. The ball was far closer to Grunty than it was from me, and she was moving in fast. However, luckily for me, she's a foolish fool, and despite actually shooting at it, hitting it, and being close enough that she could have just finished it off before I got there, she decided to randomly stop and go airborne. By the time I got there, she'd already done a fair bit of damage to the bowl, and I didn't really have much time to reposition myself, because while I was doing so, she could have probably finished it off. So, from where I was, I started out just trying to reposition the nuzzle of her laser so she couldn't hit it, but then I realized that I was actually able to achieve a fair bit of lift, and for some reason Grunty tried to reposition herself by flying over top of me, which kind of combined because we were connected, and we ended up just flying away. So I suppose what works works, and point to me, which puts me up to a Jiggy score and brings us up to round 8. Round 8 started with my hilarious inability to block her from getting past, followed by Grunty's hilarious inability to navigate a small ledge. As you can see, there was some sort of problem with her pathing or her AI or something, and luckily she clearly does not realize that the laser fires through solid objects, and so this round was really easily awarded to me. I still nudged her and span her around and whatnot because otherwise I would be bored waiting for the round to end, but because of the time she wasted, it was never really a threat. And so round 9, aka the final round, aka the last round, aka the finale of the bonus episode. This round immediately starts off rather challenging because the ball begins between the two vehicles, and because the two vehicles are the same, it's rather evenly matched. Immediately, Grunty started off with a bit of a strong start and got quite a few hits on the ball. I wasn't too worried because I already had the Jiggy score, but on the other hand, I was fairly certain that one extra point would get me the Trophy Thomas trophy, and so I was still fairly determined. Clearly though, so too was Grunty. She managed to break away from my spin and chase after the ball, scoring some rather significant hits on it. But luckily, just as in the round before where she had issues with a small ledge, her apparent depth perception issues kicked in, and she got the barrel of her laser stuck on top of the very ball she was trying to shoot. And so, in no small part due to that cock-up from Grunty, the victory was given to me, the extra point was awarded, and the Trophy Thomas trophy for the Trophy Thomas score was awarded. Which really brings us to the end of this Witch v Witch bonus video. If you would like to try the challenge yourself, after I stop talking in a couple of seconds, as always, there'll be the layer by layer of this vehicle so you can replicate it yourself and give it a shot. And with all of that said and done, thanks for watching, and until next time, I have been and still am Grim Grindel. Scott.